good to be home.
Good to be home.
It's good to be home.
Good to be home.
So good to be home.
Do you hear that playing?
Yes, I hear that playing.
Do you know who's playing?
No, who is that playing?
Well, it's Gabriel, Gabriel playing. Gabriel, Gabriel saying, will you be ready to go when I blow my horn? Oh, blow, Gabriel, blow.
Blow, Gabriel,
oh, blow, Gabriel, blow. Yes, I've been a sinner, I've been a scamp, but now I'm willing to trim my lamp. So blow, Gabriel, blow.
Gabriel, blow.
I was low, Gabriel, low. Mighty low, Gabriel, low.
Mighty low.
But now since I've seen the light, I'm good by day and I'm good by night. So low, Gabriel,
Gabriel, low.
Once I was headed for hell.
Oh no.
Once I was headed for hell.
So low.
But when I got to Satan's door, I heard you blowing on your horn once more. So I said, Satan, farewell. I'm all ready to fly. Just fly higher and
high.
Cause I've been through the brimstone and I've been through the fire. And I purged my soul and my heart too to climb up the mountaintop and start to blow. Gabriel, blow.
Come on, Gabriel.
Go on and blow, Gabriel, blow. Oh, yes, I wanna join a happy band and play all day in the promised land. So blow, Gabriel, blow. Blow, Gabriel, blow.
Yes!
Yeah.
Great job, Devin.
Thanks. Great job, D-Mac.
Oh, I love hearing you sing that song. Hey, listen, folks, this is an action-packed episode, and so we're going to jump right back into the music. Here is a song from Devin McGlamery's solo record that he did a few years ago that won a Dove Award.
Right.
Yes.
Awesome.
A song that I helped write with Wayne Haun and Joel Lindsey. And Devin, I cannot wait for you to sing this song. It's been a while since we've heard
it.
I know that people are going to love it. It's called Rags to Riches.
Yeah, yeah.
Kick it off, guys.
Yeah, guys.
Sing, Devin. Sat beside the road of life and watched it pass me by. As I begged for crumbs of charity, but no one heard my cry. And when it seemed my destiny was that I would surely lose, the Savior came and he offered me what I could not refuse. From my rags to his riches, he made an even trade. His beauty for my ashes, and I love the deal he made. Cares he carried away. I went from rags to his riches on that day.
That's it.
Where I had conflict in my life, now I am rich in peace. And though I lived in doubt and fear, I have reason to believe that I have wealth that goes beyond all the silver and the gold. And I can't believe that he gave to me this new life for my own. From my rags to his riches, he made an even trade. His beauty for my ashes, and I love the deal he made. He carried away. I went from rags to his riches on that day. From my rags to his riches, he made an even trade. His beauty for my ashes, and I love deal he made. Now I feel like a millionaire. All my cares he carried away. I went from rags to his riches on that day. Now I feel just like he carried away. I went from rags to his riches on that day.
Amen. Great job, Devin.
Thanks, brother.
Yeah. What a song, what a song.
Man, what a song.
Travel has always enriched my life, and here are two ways you can enrich yours with us and our Creator. On June the 2nd through the 5th, 2022, we would like to invite you to the EHSS Fan Retreat in Sugar Creek, Ohio. This will be our 10th anniversary retreat. The event takes place at Carlisle Walnut Creek Inn and the Ohio Star Theater, which sits in the Amish country. It is a way for us to gather and refresh and enjoy amazing fellowship, food, and most of all, being in one place experiencing the presence of Jesus together. Another way is to join Ernie Haase's signature sound on an upcoming cruise. Inspiration Cruises and Tours has almost 40 years of experience in hosting Christian travel events that help you connect to God and your faith in destinations around the world. Ernie Haase's signature sound, along with Michael W. Smith and friends, will be ministering on a cruise to Alaska on July the 2nd through the 9th, 2022. For additional information, it's all at erniehaase.com. We hope to see you there. Thanks.
Well, for those of you who follow us on social media, you know the press release we put out a few weeks ago. But for those of you who are seeing it for the first time, Devin McGlamery, who's been here 12 years, is transitioning to another ministry. And we had a conversation with Devin. We talk about it here. And so I'm going to play you an excerpt of that interview. To see the full-length interview with Devin McGlamery, just go to erniehaase.com and click on the TV show link at the top. Here's a heartfelt conversation that I hope blesses your heart with Devin McGlamery. Listen. Hey, everybody. Ernie Haase here, and we have some, I guess if this was a real TV show, we would say breaking news, and there'd be like a banner at the bottom. And so to help me tell this news, I'm bringing in to the chat room here my brother, Devin McGlamery. Hey, Devin.
Hey, Ernie. How are you, man?
Well, We're a little nervous, folks. Our laughing is a little bit of mixed with sorrow and nerves, too. So let's just tell everybody what's going on.
Sure, man.
Devin, you know what? You probably articulate it better than I can, and then maybe I can fill in the blanks after you share your good news.
Sure. Well, quick backstory. When we took some time off back a while due to COVID and shutdown and things like that, I actually, the day after the press release went out, I got a phone call, and long story short, I went on staff with a company called the Fellowship of Christian Athletes. Mm-hmm. It's just been great. It's just been so good. I mean, God has just tendered my heart to that. Been around sports my whole life, and especially ministry. And as God would have it, and we trust His timing because it's perfect. He's transitioned and moved us into a new season. And I was talking to a friend of mine on the phone today, and And I said, you know, Ernie and I talked recently, and he, I remember the question. He said, man, how's your heart? Where's your heart at? And I said, I just felt this overwhelming peace. And just, man, he said, you know what? I knew that, you know? And so that's kind of what, I guess that's, we hadn't really talked about how to get into it. That's kind of what this video is about, is we've just begun the transition process for my role with Signature Sound to be filled and me to transition into full-time ministry with the Fellowship of Christian Athletes.
Yeah. So this is what I want people to know. Devin's been here 12 years, and he's the most loyal guy I've ever met in my life, you know. And God's given me some loyal people, so I'm not trying to choose which one's most loyal. But what I'm just saying is, you know, Devin has had my back so many times. And so when I asked you that question, where's your heart? I knew probably in December you and I were going to have that talk, because things have exploded for you with FCA. And so I knew in December, but then this last couple of weeks, I'm just like, I told Lisa, I said, I feel like I need to give Devin permission to say what's really on his heart, or it may fester and it may come out in a way that, you know, that friends don't want it to come out. And so I called Devin last week and I said, hey, tell me what's on your heart. And he said, I'm with you 100%. I wanted to be with you till you retired. and he said, but when I walk off the stage, my heart's gone. And I had big tears in my eyes. I'm holding them back now. But
me too,
Devin. I don't look at it as you leaving. I just look at this as an extension of a ministry. Lisa and I we support you.
You do.
And we have supported you. We're going to continue to support you.
Yes,
and
sir.
So, ladies and gentlemen, you got to understand. I don't have kids. So these are my kids. It's so kind of like big brother, little brother thing.
Sure.
And, you know, the Bible talks about you got to leave home and you got to go forge your own trails. Here's the, I guess we just need to turn the page and say, the last thing I asked you was the same question I asked Doug Anderson 6 years ago. You've been here 12 years. You've owned that slot on the front line of this quartet.
Thanks, man.
Who do you want to replace you? I mean,
well,
now I gotta start
it's funny. Well, Signature Sound being a family, you know, I can't help but want a family member to come take this spot if it was the right time. And before I say the name, I remember you saying, "Why don't you call him and see if it's the right time? See if this is what God is just working out and unfolding." And so, can I introduce the guy, Ernie?
You can, and let me play producer here. There you go. All right, I'm ready.
All right, so the new member of Signature Sound happens to be already a family member. Would you make welcome my brother, Mr. Doug Anderson?
Oh,
I feel like I should clap for you.
I do.
I'm tearing up. Dadgummit.
I am too. I am listening to you guys talk, and you know, it's hard for me to be silent, but listening to you guys talk, I'm just, the emotions are like coming out in me like crazy. There has never been a more loyal person than Devin McGlamery in my life. I mean, he is just, dude, you are truly a brother. And when Ernie called, which Ernie is more of a, to all of us, and you'll say this as well, he's not only a brother and a boss, but he's a mentor. And when Ernie called and said, hey, would you be willing to fill in with Devin? The first person I call is one of my best friends in the world, Devin McGlamery, and say, hey, are you okay with this? And Devin, in true Devin fashion, said, well, yeah, I would rather it be you than anybody else.
Oh.
So I love that. And we've, you know, through not only, you know, the FCA time, but the COVID time, we've talked so many different times.
Yeah.
And how it's progressed. I'm thankful and I'm grateful because I love this family, but I'm also grateful that because I was in the exact same spot that Devin was 6 years ago. My kids were young. My kids were involved in so many things. God had given me an opportunity to spread my wings through Ernie Haase and Signature Sound. But it was a chance where Ernie always said, hey, go do your thing. And, you know, Lord bless you. And he did tremendously. Now those kids are a little older. they're in college, they're, you know, they're doing their own stuff, and we're at a different spot in our life.
Sure.
And same spot that you and Karen are in right now, and I couldn't commend you more for not only what you're doing for your family, but what you're doing with the things that God's blessed you with, man. And kudos to you, Devin McGlamery, and Ernie Haase for being that person that says, go do your thing.
Yeah.
And I appreciate you both so much.
Back at you, brother.
I knew when we named the record Keeping On and that we were going to go out and sing the song, I'm here to tell you, keep on keeping on, that we were going to be put in situations as a group, individually and collectively, to show what keeping on looks like. And so that's scary, isn't it? Because you're kind of like inviting challenges, but you know what? There's only two ways to look at a challenge. You can say, you can get ticked, you can get mad, you can get bitter, and you can fight. Or you can be like Mary when she found out that she was going to birth the Savior of the world. She questioned it at first, and then finally she said, let it be unto me as you say. So you know what? God's ways are not our ways, but we know he's working all things for our good.
Absolutely.
And there is going to be an eternal weight of glory by the way we respond to the challenges in our lives. So I couldn't be more proud of you guys. And I'm excited for many, on many different levels. And so,
of course,
I'm happy for, I hate to use the word fans, but I'm happy for our fans too, because, we're keeping it in the family. I feel good about this. I feel really good about
too.
This. And a lot of things going on in our culture today, and we need mentors and we need some guys to step up and
absolutely,
and to lead these young men and young women and show them the Christ-like character that can be forged. And so Devin, you're on the mission field, buddy. And
buddy,
you always got a, you know, this whole TV series of Good to Be Home, you always got a home. You can always come back home. This is your home.
And we means the world,
called,
man.
To do it. There's
I know
nobody
that.
Better, buddy.
I appreciate it, bro.
Well, you guys get back to your day, and thanks for taking the time. And
I will
talk to you soon. And you guys who are watching, everybody who's watching, say a prayer for Signature Sound, that we will keep on keeping on showing the love of Christ however he leads. Amen.
Amen.
That's it.
Guys, I know you've seen that interview before, but I've seen it at least half a dozen times, and it still moves me to my core. And there's these little nuances and things that we said, Devin, that it's just coming home to me in a new found way.
Sure.
So that's what the Spirit does. And we know that there are people who are watching who are transitioning in their lives, many, many ways that takes shape and form. So hopefully the Spirit is taking what's happening here and applying it to your transition in life, and that you are keeping your friendship first and foremost, no matter what happens.
Yeah.
That relationship is what matters most.
Yeah.
Well, here's a song that, if I had to pick my favorite Devin McGlamery song of all his years with Signature Sound, that's hard to do, but it would be this one right here. And matter of fact, Devin, I think this is the first song that you sang the lead vocals on that was a number one song for us.
Right. That's correct.
And so I think it's fitting that you sing this song on this episode that is featuring you and honoring you, my brother.
Thanks, man.
Here is That's Why I Love Him So.
He knew we'd be so lost without him. That's why he left heaven's throne. Come as a child to the wicked and wild, not to condemn but atone. He knew that we needed forgiveness. That's why his mercy was free. When all hope was lost, he became the cost to ransom a sinner like me. And I am living in the promise. There is grace for every need. He knew His precious blood flow. And I do believe every drop was for me, and that's why I love Him so. Oh, He knew that we all needed healing, and that's why He took every stripe, the hammer and nails, all the anguish He felt was torment that should have been mine. But He could see hope in the making for someone as hopeless as
me. Yeah, that's right.
And that's why He rose over death He imposed, so we all could forever go free. And I am living in the promise. There is grace,
there's so much grace
for every need, for every single need. He knew that we needed a Savior, that's why His precious blood flowed. And I do believe every drop was for me, and that's why I love Him so. I do believe every drop was for me, and that's why I love Him so.
After the show, head over to erniehaase.com by typing erniehaase.com into your web browser. There you will find our new website. You can also follow all the happenings of EHSS by finding your favorite social media platform in the upper right-hand corner. And while you're there, be sure to sign up for my free email newsletter. About once a month, I send out a personal email with inspirational writings and all the signature sound happenings. If you'd like to schedule Ernie Haase's signature sound for a future event or concert, you can do so by clicking here. And if you'd like to know more about each team member, you can do that by clicking the bio page. And if you want to know more about all the music we've created over the past 15 years, click the music page. And if you'd like to support the music ministry of Ernie Haase's signature sound, well, you can do so by picking up our CDs and DVDs and LPs and all the fun materials we've created by clicking the store tab. And finally, we'd like to encourage you to click the partner tab. If you really want to see the Good to Be Home TV series continue, we'd like your help by becoming a partner. You can do so weekly, monthly, or with a one-time pledge, or however you feel led. Thank you so much, and now, back to the show.
A big thank you to everyone who has helped support Signature Sound. Through your prayers, through this transition and all the transition, you've been so faithful, and God has blessed us because of you. And on a side note, if you love Devin like I know you do, you'll want to go check out his solo CD on our website. Those two songs he sang tonight, That's Why and Rags to Riches, is on that solo CD. So proud of Devin and expecting great things to come. Well, you know how much I enjoy introducing you to my friends, and this next man is no stranger to gospel music, and there's no way I could have planned this. It's so fitting that God allowed him to be with us here on this episode of Friendship. And because of time constraints, we've edited down his interview also. So to see the full-length interview, go to erniehaase.com and click on the TV show link. Here is a wonderful interview, a portion of it, with my friend, Michael W. Smith. Enjoy.
Hey, Smitty.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. I appreciate that. I'm glad we get to connect. It's been a while. So.
It has been a while. I think the last time that I got to see you, except in passing at the Dove Awards and stuff, that doesn't really count. We got to tour with you back in 2012. We went to Australia together, didn't we?
I think so.
Do you remember that?
It was a long time ago, wasn't it?
It was too long.
I'm not even sure we can go to Australia now. How about that?
I know. I want to back up. I want to go back to the beginning of your career. And it's been a long, distinguished career. But did I read right? Am I remembering correctly that the first group that you were ever in, performed with, was it a gospel quartet?
Yeah, it was Higher Ground. You probably know Wayne Hilliard.
Yes, indeed. Yeah.
Yeah, so 1980.
Okay.
Crazy to think about that. I mean, just insane. I mean, I had, it's a crazy story. The short story is that, you know, I kind of went through a prodigal season and have written books about it. You get all the crazy, gory details and how amazing it was when God rescued me, thanks to the prayers of my mom and dad. But that was from 75 to 79. I moved to Nashville in 78. And I remember having this, I really had a nervous breakdown, honestly, in 1979. And then twisted and turned for 3.5 hours on the floor. Mm-hmm. And then felt like, knew beyond a shadow of a doubt, that Abba Father was laying on the ground with me in my kitchen floor with his arm around me and said, "It's going to be okay. I got your back." I mean, it was like a movie. And I remember waking up the next day and said, "God, I need a rescue, man. Whatever happened last night was the real deal." So, you know, and you wake up and you're tempted to go do the same things. And then I went into a publishing company, a Paragon publishing company at the time, and Randy Cox was my publisher. And he asked me to come to his office. And he said, "Hey," I said, it's a wild idea. There's this group called Higher Ground, and they're looking for a piano player." I said, "I'll take the job." He said, "You don't want to meet him?" I said, "Nope, I'll take the job." And they nurtured me back to health spiritually for the next eight months. And that's how I kind of got back on my feet, was with Wayne and Lee, Wayne's brother.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And I guess the rest is history. Then, you know, 8 months later, I got my first songwriting contract where I actually got paid $200 a week. I thought I'd die and gone to heaven. and then I met a girl named Amy Grant. Started writing songs for the A-Stage record and found myself on the road with her. So it's just wild how God just sort of orchestrates all that stuff. You can't take credit for it. So
I just wanted to chat with you because for the last, since we started this season of The Good to Be Home, I've been telling everybody that we're going to Alaska, not just Alaska, but we're going with you. And I just thank you for inviting Signature Sound. We've been looking for opportunities to not only work together, but to hang out.
Yeah. Well, thank you. I'm so glad you guys are coming. It's going to be awesome. This will probably be my fourth or fifth time to Alaska. You've been there. You've probably been on the Gaither Cruise. And we talked about David Jeremiah. David actually went on one of my cruises back in the day. But it's just, you know, the Alaska is spectacular in of itself. It's just majestic. And
yeah.
I'm a big outdoors guy. I can just look at a mountain and sort of kind of get in praise mode. Just, you know, looking at the stars in Alaska and look at the mountains and the glaciers and stuff. But the people really make it. You know, the people who come on the boat, you know, I've got these amazing, I don't really call them fans, I call them friends. You know, they become friends and they're supportive. And I'm convinced I'm still doing what I'm doing because they pray for me every day. They're pretty loyal, you know.
Absolutely.
And so, you know, we're going to have a good group and we're going to have a lot of people come because you guys are coming. I know that for sure.
I've talked to many people behind your back about you you know, the two things that keep coming up to the forefront constantly is you're always working. You love the process, I should say.
Yeah.
And your genuineness, your realness, your sweetness, the encounters with you are not just, "Oh, he's nice." No, they have encounters with you and they feel like they've taken up a piece of you with them as they walk away. So that's why I'm sure everybody on that boat will think that they are your personal friend, because in some ways they really are. And so that's influenced me and how I hate to say do business, but how I handle the business of my ministry and with my guys. And so I want to thank you for that.
Well, thank you. I haven't always done everything right, you know, but as you get older, you really realize it's not about you. And, you know, you want to kill people with kindness, you know, just be kind. And I'm not any more important than anybody else. We're all in this thing together. And you know, you just want to have your A game on. You know, I found out that I can't change the past. I don't know what tomorrow holds. I have this moment. It's all I got. So live in the moment. So that's what I think I've gotten better at it, and I'm still learning. But just even if it's on stage, or even if it's just I just went to the grocery store, be in the moment for
whoever's
waiting on you. So, you know, because I always think worship's lifestyle. You know, you just it's too late to miss it. You know, and there's so many opportunities, not only on the stage but off the stage as well.
Living in the moment, staying in the now, and just trusting God with the rest of it.
That's right.
I remember at soundcheck, you walked off the stage and you just did a little bit of Friends or Friends Forever, if the Lord of them. I remember you smiling and you said, I never dreamed when I wrote that song I'd still be singing it 30 years later. But you are.
Crazy. I mean, I always tell Deb, I laugh because my wife wrote the lyric. You know, we wrote it for a good friend of ours. You know, we wrote it spur of the moment. You know, she wrote the lyric in 30 minutes. I wrote the music in 3.5 minutes. We played it for our friend Bill that night. This is my wife's wild idea to write a song for Bill Jackson, who was leading our Bible study. He was moving away, and she had this wild idea to write a song that day and sing it that night. And I thought, she's crazy. They ain't gonna happen, girl. It's not gonna happen. And 30 minutes later, she hands me this lyric, and then I write the music in 3.5 minutes, and we sing it for Bill that night. And everybody cried, and you know. And I woke up the next morning, and I went, you know, there might be something on this song. And I thought Amy would cut it. I thought, I'm going to pitch this song to Amy. I'll never forget my manager at the time, Mike Blanton. Never forget being in an elevator, and I was picking songs from my very first record, the Michael W. Smith Project. And I remember him vividly looking at me going, you know what, Amy doesn't need to cut this song, you do.
Oh, wow.
And so, but Amy and I have sung it together so many times. I mean, we ended the Age to Age tour with that song almost every night, and I think even the Lead Me On tour, we just have sung it so much. But whatever, yeah, it's crazy. When you look out there and you see people light up, you see people crying, you see people hugging, and you know the song becoming a huge fabric of people's lives. It's crazy. You know, I never thought it was like this amazing song, but sometimes songs come along that there's just something simplistic about it, and that it just connects. And I think it's just that's one of those songs.
Well, I've quoted the lyric even to my neighbor across the street. They downsized, and he's going through the beginning stages of Parkinson, and you know, it's life is a series. I'm getting closer to 60 now, so it's been a series of losses. Whether it's not either death or goodbyes or see you later's, even within my own group of Signature Sound. Transitioning from different vocalists, and man, it's hard, but because you become, I think it was Gaither told me this one time, you know, business brings you together, but then the friendship happens, and then when the business stops, can the friendship survive? And I'm proud of my friends. I'm proud that I have friends that have lasted longer than business. And, well, I can't think of a more fitting song for this episode, especially with everything that's going on in my crazy life, than your wonderful, simplistic, but yet profound song, Friends Are Friends Forever. Do you think we could back you up? Would you bless the people with your song?
Absolutely.
Let's
done deal. Let's do it.
Let's do that.
All right. In the fertile soil of you, I can't believe the hopes he's granted. Each chapter in your life is true, but we'll keep you close as always.
it won't even see you go. 'Cause our hearts in big and small ways keep the love that keeps us strong. Friends are friends forever, if the Lord's the Lord of them. And a friend will not say never, 'cause the welcome will not end. Though it's hard to let you go, in the Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long.
A lifetime's not too long.
Yeah, that's right. God's given, springing from the hope we know. And we will pray the joy you'll live in is the strength that now you show. We'll keep you close as always. It won't see you go, 'cause our hearts in big and small ways keep the love that keeps us strong. Friends are friends forever, if the Lord's the Lord of them. And a friend will not say never, so welcome will that end. Though it's hard to let you go, Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long.
A lifetime's not too long
to live as friends. Friends are friends forever, if the Lord's the Lord of them. And a friend will not say never, 'cause so welcome will that end. Though it's hard to let you go, the Father's hand we know, and the lifetime's not too long,
the lifetime's not too long
to live as friends. Though the lifetime's not too long to live as friends.
Amen. Friends are friends forever, if the Lord's the Lord of them. A big thank you to Michael W. Smith, to Devin McGlamery, for 12 years of faithful service. We're expecting big things from you, Devin. And welcome to Signature Sound, my buddy. Original member, Doug Anderson. Yeah, life would be so bleak without friends. So I'm thankful for the friends in my life. I'm thankful for you. And I'm thankful for the friend above all other friends, Jesus Christ. And what a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. And what a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Jesus is the friend you've been looking for. God bless you. See you next week. I'm good to be home.
So good to be home.